Hello people, I'm Carlos and this is Our Knowledge. Welcome to my Blender Basic tutorial series. This is the video number 4 about graphic user interface and personalization. First, let me tell you what I'm going to show you in this video. I'm going to teach you some important user preferences that will save your work more than one time. Second, I'm going to show you how to personalize your Blender graphic user interface and your layout to fit your needs and improve your workflow. And last but not least, I'm going to show you how to use the preset layouts that come with Blender. Okay guys, this is the Blender 2.7 stable release. If you notice, now we have a new user interface. Now the tools are classified into tabs, so you can find them easily. But first, let me show you the user preferences, okay? Go to the File menu, into the User Preferences option, and into the File tab. The most important thing I want to teach you this lesson is the Autosave section. I recommend you to check the Keep section so Blender will load the last project you was working on when you closed Blender. Okay, the autosave temporary files, I recommend you to have the timer in 1 minute. That way you will not lose a lot of work when Blender crashes just because you forgot to save your work. Okay guys, let's go to the system tab. This DPI value is the size of your user interface, and your price is one of the biggest Blender video tutorial maker, and he recommends that this DPI value stays at 100. The sound format, there is SDL format, and is used for video sequence editor. The OpenAL format supports 3D audio. It's recommended for game engine. For example, when you get closer to an object that generates some kind of sound, the sound will get stronger. The screencast section is for video tutorial purpose. Compute device. If you don't have any GPU, you will see none and you only have the CPU option to choose. But if you have multiple GPUs, you can choose CUDA or CUDA and you will see your GPUs in this section. For example, I only have the GeForce GT740M. Here in the sequencer or clip editor, I recommend you to get this memory cache limit to the value of 2048 for the sake of bigger projects, okay? And last, the international fonts. This one lets you translate your user interface. But I don't recommend you to translate your user interface because most tutorials are in English. So when they tell you to use some kind of tool, you will not be able to find the tool because you have the user interface in your own language. Okay guys, let's go to the interface tab. You want to check tooltip and discard Python tooltips. The Python tooltips are the purple text that shows at the right of my mouse. They are only useful for developers, so you want to uncheck so it doesn't appear and distract you. Okay? Show splash is for showing the splash screen every time you open Blender. Sometimes the splash screen shows you some useful information. And prompt quit. This one will prevent you from exiting Blender without saving your work. Okay guys, let's go to the editing tab. Here the only thing that worth teaching you is the undo section. In the steps, you have to get it to the top, 64 steps, and the memory limit to 0, so it has unlimited memory. That way you can work safer knowing that you can undo 64 steps. Here in the duplicate data, You can choose which attribute can be duplicated with the object in the scene. Okay, I usually copy all when I do duplicates. Okay guys, let's go to the input tab. Here you can configure the keyboard shortcuts for Blender. Okay, I recommend you to check continuous grab. When you are performing an action and you reach the end of the screen, continuous grab will let you keep performing the action in the same direction. Okay. Now, if you have a laptop, I recommend you to check emulate 3 button mouse and emulate numpad in case you don't have a numpad or a 3 button mouse. Everything else in my Blender in the input tab is at default. Now let's go to the add-ons tab. Okay guys, this is the add-ons tab. Here you can download and install different add-ons to help you in your day-to-day work in Blender. For example, the copy attributes menu will let you copy some attributes from one object to another, like textures and armatures. But you don't have to worry about this right now. I will let you in the future a list of add-ons that will be useful. Okay. Now, in the themes tab, you can configure the way Blender looks. For example, Ubuntu Ambiase, Hexagon, Elysium, Blender 24x, the default theme of Blender, very like Blender 24x, and the Back to Black theme. All these are presets. My theme is a modification of Back to Black in the user interface and in the 3D view. Why using this theme is because Andrew Price recommends in one of his tutorials some things about the 3D view and the colors in the user interface. Okay, you should check Andrew Price tutorial about this, but if you don't find the tutorial, stick to the default theme. Okay. Now let's get into the user interface of Blender. Okay. Okay, guys. Let me show you the Blender user interface. In the top here, you can see the info bar. If you use right click, you can collapse the menus. You have the file menu, render menu, window menu, and the help menu that has the splash screen at the bottom. Here is the layout selector. You can create your own layout, but I don't recommend you doing so if you don't know what you are doing. Okay. The presets available for Blender are 3D view full, animation, compositing, default, game logic, motion tracking, scripting, UV editing, and video editing. You most likely will be spending your time in the default layout. Okay. This is the scene selector. When you have more than one scene in one project, but this I will teach you about this in the future. This is the render engine selector. If you have more than one render engine installed, you can choose which one you want to use. In my videos, it's probably I will be using Cycles render engine and sometimes the internal Blender render engine for my tutorials. And last, we have here information about our Blender, the version and the splash screen, number of vertices, faces, triangles, objects, lamps, the memory used, and the currently selected object like the plane or Suzanne, the mascot of the Blender Foundation. Okay. On the left we have the tool panel. The tabs are the tool tab for transform, edit, and history tools, the create tab for adding mesh objects, curves, dumps, and other objects. The relations are for adding groups, set parents, and other things related to relations things. The animation tab is for inserting keyframes, motion paths, and animating objects. Okay. The physics tabs is for adding rigid objects, rigid body to objects, and things related to physics. And the gray pencil is for drawing over objects like this. As you can see, it depends on the position of the camera. Okay. Here on the right is the outliner. This outliner is like a list of the objects in the scene. If I make a copy of the scene, you can see that the objects are different. This is another plane different of the plane of the first scene. Right? Since they are different scenes, you can see they are different objects. This outliner will show you all the objects in this scene and in the other scene, if you want to see them. Down here is the properties panel. This property panel have property for render layers, for properties of the scene, world, object, constraints, modifiers, object data, material, and texture. Okay, guys, the last thing I'm going to show you is this. This is the timeline. This is mostly for animation, so I'm not going to show you nothing about this until we get in that part in the future. The last thing I'm going to tell you is learn your way into Blender. Read the shortcuts, the tooltips, so you can learn the shortcuts. That way you will be faster working in Blender just using the shortcuts instead of going into the tool panel and search for the tool you want to use. For example, if you wanna add a circle, you have to go to the create tab and search for the circle, right? Instead of that, UV sphere. Instead of doing that, you can use Shift A to pop up the add menu and search for mesh and UV sphere. It's the fastest way. Okay, guys, this is all. Thank you for watching. Please comment and subscribe for my next video tutorials. Tell me what do you think of, for example, my pronunciation, and what words were misspelled, so I can correct that for the next tutorial, and put some comments, some annotations to the video in the parts that you don't understand. Okay, that's all. Thank you for watching, and have a nice day.